Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. As promised, in this video I'm going to show you how you can almost guarantee buying an NFT that you desire. And just to show you that this isn't a gimmick, I'll walk you through some of the NFTs I bought so far. So on the last drop, the Ultraman, as you can see, I managed to get two NFTs on this one. And then we'll also go to the other ultra rare Batman Nightwing. So I'll just go to that quickly just so you guys can see. Let's just go to that. Sorry, there we go. As you can see, I also got a Nightwing as well. So as you can see, there's one ultra rare and one rare that I've managed to purchase using this strategy. Now, I've actually managed to buy almost every single NFT. No, sorry, not almost. Every single NFT that I've wanted on this app so far, I've managed to buy from day one using the strategies in this video. So make sure you're taking notes. And again, guys, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And as always, click the bell notification icon so you can stay up to date on all my recent videos. In fact, pause this video, go to my description and click that Telegram link so you have the heads up over everybody else with other cryptocurrencies, gems, and just general updates as well. So make sure you click that Telegram link right now and join that so you can stay up to date. Now, let's get into the video. So we'll start off with step-by-step how I do this. So number one, I make sure that my gems are loaded up the day before. Sounds obvious, but a lot of people aren't doing this. Your gems have to be loaded up the day before so you're not faffing around, you know, trying to buy gems, etc. You already have your gems loaded up, which means that you could immediately start buying once you're on the platform. Number two, you also have to make sure you know what you're buying, right? So if you don't know what you're buying, let's say, for example, on the Ultraman drop, this almost happened to me, actually. I didn't know that this wasn't out, the Ultra Rare. I had no idea that this was out. So I was there literally waiting for this to, you know, to come about. But unfortunately, it wasn't available. Now, luckily, I was still able to actually buy an Ultraman Ace. But my point is, suppose you're on this one, then you click off this one, you don't know what you're gonna buy. By the time you've decided, the ultra rare and the rare will be sold out. You may be able to get a common and uncommon, but the point is to get the actual ultra rares and rares, you need to know what you want and be prepared for this in advance. Also, the most common issue that I hear is people saying they're unable to get onto the app, right? This is the strategy that I use. I'm on the app half an hour at least. At least you should be on the app 10 to 20 minutes beforehand, and you should be waiting in not just the loading page, but you should already be on, for example, let's just go to drops. You should already be on here, right? And then you're literally refreshing and you're waiting for it to become available. And as soon as it's available, you start buying, right? You don't wait off the app, or you don't just wait in this loading page and you know, wait to be able to buy it, because what could end up happening is, again, it's going to be super laggy, it's going to be super frozen, and of course it can be very stressful to you not knowing what's going on. And that's what I'm saying, a lot of people end up clicking off the app, and then that, because it's slow, and they believe if they're able to go back on the app it'll be faster. That is not the case, guys, and this is why a lot of people are getting locked out of the app, unable to buy the NFTs, or, you know, they log back on and there's no difference. So make sure whatever happens, you're on the app. That's the most important takeaway from this video. You need to be on the app at least 10 to 20 minutes before. And again, the last drop, as you could see, it was extended for about 1 hour. They actually turned the servers off as well, but even then I did not click off the app. I made sure I stayed on the app. This is the golden rule here. You have to be on the app 10 to 20 minutes, at least 30 minutes beforehand. And even if there's any changes to the time, you make sure you stay on. Also, guys, another thing I would like to add is you have to ensure that, oh yeah, I did already say you have to make sure that you know what you want, etc. But once you're on the app and you go to buy your NFT, what you're going to see is, so for example, let's say this is it, you click on it, let's say Ultraman 7. So you click on that, it won't be as fast as that, it may be laggy. Now it will say buy now. When you click on the buy now icon, what you're going to experience is, it's probably going to say error, right? It's probably going to say error. Ignore that. You keep on clicking buy now until eventually it allows you to buy. This can happen 10 to 20, no, 20 to 20, not 10, sorry, 20 to 30 times even. So you just click on buy now, it's gonna say error, try again. You just keep on doing it until eventually it allows you to buy. Now, what could happen is this, there's two things that can happen. Number one, it gives you the option to buy now straight away, and congratulations, it means you've got your you've processed it. Now, what I will say is, once it gives you the option to process, do not mess around. You click on buy now straight away. Straight away. If you don't do that, I'm sorry, but it's gonna basically make you start the whole process again. This happened to me on the last drop because my screen went black because I panicked, and then I had to start the whole process again and keep on clicking. I got the error message over and over again. And then when it did allow me to buy, it gave me the option to buy 5, but either way, just knowing what happened before, I clicked on buy now. It only allowed me to buy, so only it took out 5 worth of gems. So my account was, as you can imagine, this happened across the board. A lot of people's accounts end up in a minus, but nevertheless, I still got my 2 rare NFTs, and they ended up refunding the gems back to me after this process. And I actually got an apology. For those of you that this happened to, you would have received the same email, the apology, etc. But yeah, so that's that. You're going to get the error message. You just have to keep making sure that you keep on doing it no matter what. Also, do not be distracted, right? On the Telegram group, you're going to see a lot of people saying it's sold out, or they've bought 10 or something along those lines. Don't be distracted by that. Number one, they're probably doing that just to psych you out, to stop you from buying, so it gives them a chance to buy. Or number two, they may be genuine, but what's happening is we're seeing NFTs, all the NFTs separated into different regions. So they may allocate a certain number to, let's say, Europe, then they may allocate another number to the US and another number to Europe, etc. So it'll be very much separated. So just because you see someone saying sold out doesn't mean it'll be sold out in your region. So make sure you keep trying until it tells you on the system sold out. If it doesn't say sold out, you keep buying. And even if it does say sold out, if it gives you the option to buy, you keep on buying, right? So yeah, so you have to make sure you do that. So again, guys, the main takeaways is, number one, you have to make sure your gems are loaded up in advance. Number two, you have to make sure that you know what you would like to buy. That's very important. And then number three, you have to make sure you're on the app 10 to 20 minutes, I'll say 30 minutes beforehand. And whatever happens, you do not click off. I don't care how slow it is. I don't care if it's frozen. You stay on the app. This, guys, for this strategy to work, you must follow this step by step. You have to make sure you're on the app. Even if it freezes for 10, 20 minutes, you stay on the app, or you just simply click refresh like this. You keep refreshing. Once you get that error message, which you likely will get with the ultra rares and rares, you just keep on doing it until eventually you're able to do it. For the Nightwing drop, I believe it took me nearly 30 minutes to an hour just to, I just kept on clicking it till eventually I got my Nightwing, right? And guys, so far this has worked for me. As you can see, I got the most sought after NFTs in this space that you just saw. So yeah, every single NFT without fail. Of course, I don't want to jinx it, because who knows, on this drop, I don't want, I don't want to not be able to, purchase, etc. But with that being said, guys, this is a massive opportunity overall. Many people are focused purely on the OMI coin, but the NFTs is a huge potential for long-term, especially quite a lot of wealth can be generated via these NFTs. And I'm going to explain why on another video right after this. So make sure that you're subscribed, you click that link in my description for the Telegram group, and you stay tuned for that next video. And remember, guys, nothing that you saw in this video was financial advice as well. But with that being said, guys, when others are fearful, be greedy. When others are greedy, be fearful. I hope you all enjoyed this video, and I hope it really did help. If you do have any more questions, just comment below. But yeah, with that being said, guys, seize the day.